afternoon to everybody present here, respected Rupa ma'am, Meghna ma'am. Thank you so much for giving us this platform, Meghna ma'am. And I really feel, you know, I'm surrounded by women who force me to, you know, level up my game. That is the kind of feeling when I got when I entered here. And like I said, first of all, a very happy Women's Day to everybody. And I am Shubhra Chaturvedi, an entrepreneur, director of T-Trans Education, a poet, a writer, and I very proudly say that I am the first plus-size model of not only Allahabad, but of Uttar Pradesh. And being a plus-size model in a city where, like I say, always say people don't even understand the concept of plus-size, they always say, "Lambi chaudi hai, ban gayi model." And maine apne talk mein bhi pehle kaha tha, is it that easy to become a model and walk the ramp with celebrities? It's not. You need certain kind of confidence. You need to be in love with your body. You need to be very, very confident and comfortable in your skin. And I really thank my mother, who is not here. I mean, as of now, she's not here. She's at home. Mrs. Preeti Chaturvedi, she has actually made me what I am. So first of all, though, I'd like to thank her. And today, the unsung diva, Mrs. Nivedita, she is a research scholar at MNIT. She has been an assistant professor for the past 14 years, a fitness freak. She's fierce, she's independent, she's a very doting mother, a very loving wife, a very, very caring daughter-in-law, a very responsible daughter, a very protective, I don't call her my friend, she's like an elder sister to me, she's a very, very protective friend. And I really, really want to see her win, because she makes me feel that, you know, I get the feeling of being a moonlight, you know, when I'm with her. And I want her to bridge that gap of being recognized as an unsung diva. For me, she's already a woman of substance, right? But I want her to be recognized as a woman of substance, right? And not an unsung diva. So I really want her to bridge that gap. And one feeling that I got before I give the mic to ma'am, another feeling that I got here when I came, Meghna ma'am, that, okay, individually, all of us are very, very strong. But together, we are unstoppable. That is what I feel, you know. We are actually unstoppable. I'd just like to end with a few lines. These are written by me, and I'm quite proud of these lines. I might fumble a bit, ma'am. Aaj ki nari ko abla ya kamzor samajhne ki galti mat karna. Pinjron mein qaid unke sapne mat karna. Aaj ki nari ambar hai, koi sheeshe ki diwar nahi. Wo apne aap mein paripoorn shakti hai. Kisi sashaktikaran ki mohtaaj nahi.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Nivedita Srivastava, and happy Women's Day to all of you. And on this important day, I would like to share a few thoughts of mine with you all. Recently, I watched this movie called Thappad, and there's a very interesting scene in this which I would like to share with all of you. There's a woman who is single, super successful, who buys a brand new car for herself. Her neighbor notices this and asks her in a toxic, typical masculine tone, "Isne fir ek nayi gaadi le li? Aisa ye karti kya hai?" Hinting subtly at her character and morals, which definitely must have been compromised to reach at the top, because that is what the societal gossips think, that women who reach at the top do such kind of things. So when this man says ki aisa ye karti kya hai jiski wajah se isne fir se ek nayi gaadi le li, to his wife in a very gentle manner subtly snaps at him, "Mehnat karti hai." And this is the moment which we all should appreciate, acknowledge and cherish: a woman taking stand for other women, a woman saving the grace and dignity of other women. We should be more compassionate towards each other. Instead of reasoning out or pulling each other's legs for each other's mistakes, rather than we should understand each other. And I take immense pride in declaring this, that we are entering into an era where women are making room for each other, adjusting to each other's temperaments, adjusting to each other's needs, and paving way for each other's success. I'm a mother of two, a wife, a daughter, a daughter-in-law, a sister-in-law. And I must say that how important all these roles have been in my life, in each and every different phase of my life, did that take my identity away from me? No. And this is precisely because of the women in my life who have pushed me hard to achieve my goals. So I would just like to say that this is an era in which we are in terms with the society, and women can really coexist with men. For that, we may be different with each other, but the similarities and struggles with which we face are pretty much the same. So we need to be more compassionate and loving towards each other. And in the end, I would just sum up that empowerment is not just for our encouragement, because we don't need it at all. We women already are health strong. And I would just say that all of you sitting here inspire me to push my limits a bit more. So power to all of us, and cheers to womanhood. Thank you so much.
Thank you.